फ्रेंड्स, यू आर वॉचिंग हिंदुस्तान ओपिनियन डॉट कॉम. टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट विच इज बेस्ड ऑन COVID-19 एंड अवर इकोनॉमी ऑल्सो. फ्रेंड्स, यू नो द कम्युनिकेशन इज द ग्रेट कम्युनिकेशन इज प्लेइंग ग्रेट रोल इन अवर लाइफ, सोसाइटी एंड इकोनॉमी ऑल्सो. इंटायर वर्ल्ड राइट नाउ फेसिंग COVID-19. सो अवर सब्जेक्ट इज पोस्ट COVID-19 challenges for the corporate communicators. For this healthy discussion, we have a very distinguished panelist. I would like to introduce, first of all, Mr. P.D. Hindwanji. P.D. Hindwanji was chief of corporate communication in NTPC. Right now, he is associated with various research agencies like Ernst & Young and also associated with Reliance various project. Another our guest is Mr. G.S. Bawa. G.S. Bawa was retired from Airport Authority of India. He was HOD in Corporate Communication Department. And apart from them, Mr. J.P. Sharma is also available with us. After the discussion, I want to some remarks from J.P. Sharma sir also. Let us start with Mr. G.S. Bawa sir. Sir, my basic question is that what kind of challenge right now facing the corporate communication departments and communicators in this pandemic, COVID-19 pandemic?
Okay, right. Thank you very much for bringing this talk into focus. And I thank you for gathering a good panelist, and we all are friends, we know each other, and I am sure everybody is passing through the same stressful environment. To whomsoever we talk, all old and senior citizen people are having the same issues, but to some extent they are at ease also, because there is no stress of office on them and they are comfortable. For them, lockdown was half-heartedly already accepted. So there are some good things and there are some challenging things also. You rightly said, what are the challenges of this changing time? I personally say the challenge is very grave. It's not that I want to terrorize anybody, but the challenge is a sort of make or break. The kind of lockdown which we have seen, and anybody I meet, even small vendors, small vegetable vendors, even some AC mechanic repair came. Everybody is really in panic. Sir, what will happen? There is no job, and where will I do? And then there are a lot of problems which they are facing. Even if small petty job they are getting out of some easing. So then challenges are many. Now coming to the challenges of communicators. What are the challenges? First of all, you see, communicators cannot be seen differently from the core business. If the core business is there, only communicators are there. So first of all, their own survival is going to be at stake. So I always say, I cannot say that you can put your head in the sand and you can say everything is going to be all right. It is not a hunky-dory situation. It is a really challenging situation. We upfront must accept that there is going to be a big challenge. We already had faced one challenge, and another serious challenge is going to be faced. And that challenge is going to be make or break sort of thing. Now coming to the challenges of communicators, as I told, communicators are not different from the business entity. But the first challenge which communicators are going to face is the change of paradigm shift. We were already seeing some kind of changes. We have moved from print to electronic. We have moved from electronic to digital. We have moved from digital to social media. While we were doing this all, now this business survival has become a challenge. So then challenge has shifted from now office to home. This challenge has shifted from market field to the screen. So now what is happening? The work is being performed from the home, and the activities are being handled on the screen. So everything has become in a virtual environment. So real challenge is managing the virtualization. I don't know if somebody has used this term or not, but I feel this managing virtualization is a real challenge for the communicators. another challenge. We always have been struggling for paucity of things, but we have never struggled for managing too much of things. Managing too much of things is another challenge, because we are flooded with the news, whether it is fake or not, but the news in abundance. And same thing is being repeated again and again, again and again. So this too much is being also causing a concern, and managing that is another challenge. And of course, another challenge is managing the new technology, managing the new skills. And you have seen how we have been struggling and managing to ensure that today's shows come on air. And then another challenge is challenge of speed, accuracy, precisionness, and consistency. What happens if you are talking of the same news 10 times or 100 times in a day? Somewhere you will introduce some kind of element of inconsistency, and that only will become your graveyard. So we have to ensure that everything we deliver in a speed, in accuracy, in consistency, and above all, it should be on time. The generation which is going to take the baton from us, who has rather already taken the baton from us, they cannot wait for tomorrow. They cannot wait for another second. They want the thing right there. So that challenge is there. And then, as I said, everything is happening in the air. Everything is happening in the cloud. Managing data, security of data, loss of data, that are another challenges. So I think I have frightened enough everybody. It is, the life is going to be full of challenges ahead.
Yeah. Sir, as you mentioned the challenges which facing the corporate communication, my next question with Mr. P.D. Hindwan, sir. Sir, what kind of opportunities we will have in post-corona pandemic? Because every crisis has some positive things, some opportunities, as our Prime Minister also mentioned. So, what kind of opportunities do you think that we will engage?
See, Arvindji, the total environment in the world is undergoing a big transformation. We have entered the digital era. In fact, digital era, biggest problem is that all of us have to stay connected, stay informed, stay enlightened, but be accountable. You can't be unaccountable. In PR or in corporate communication, the first condition is that all of us should be accountable. Whatever we are saying should have some basis. We can't say something fake, something impersonal. So it's the biggest challenge for us. If we have to sustain our visibility, if we have to sustain our brand value, if we have to manage crisis, if we have to highlight CSR efforts which are going on, we'll have to become computer savvy. We'll have to have a perfect knowledge of the social media, and our new team, though many friends of mine working in corporates are very well aware with social media, because they are using email, they are using WhatsApp, they are using Instagram, they are using Twitter, they are using LinkedIn, they are using, in fact, all the aspects of the camera. So they are very well aware of these things. But problem is that they should know how to use it as a central team. There should be a central team in every organization. Like NTPC has around 40-50 projects working at different places. So all the PR people should report to the central team. And central team, in fact, should decide what has to go, what has not to go to the media. Because once something is written in the media, you can't change it. And it becomes a part of the document. So, our PR team has to be very visible. They have to accept this challenge in a big way, and they have to come forward. I will give a small example here that you will be surprised that we have stakeholders. Internal stakeholders, we have external stakeholders. Internal stakeholders, most of the corporates are doing very well. They have already e-services, they have emails, they have newsletter, they have video magazines, they have other circulars which they are sending, and they're perfect. Only thing, we have to work from home now, and we have to bring this culture to this work. Second is the external stakeholder. This is a little bit tricky, because here besides email, we have to go for video chat, we have to go for interviews, we have to go for video conferencing with them, and see to it that they meet our CEO also through video chats and video conferences and get the work done. So this is a big challenge where we will have to customize, and it will take 3-4 months before everything gets customized and our CEO also become perfect in answering the questions of the press and media through that. Second thing is, as you know, it's a COVID and it impacted the total economy of the world. Most of the organizations have slowed down, or most of the organization was on the verge of shutting down also. So in this situation, we have to maintain our brand, we have to maintain our visibility, and for that, it is very necessary that we should show our brand in a big way through specific audiences, through these social media. I'm not saying brands are not doing. Brands are doing agile. Brands are very agile to this. And they are doing excellent work. But we have to reinforce this. Instead of print media, now we have to depend more on social media, because it's a social media age now. Everything will be through social media. In fact, the things were moving from Wi-Fi in 1997 when the Wi-Fi came, and then we started our work. Then came WhatsApp, Facebook, all these things came, and then we became perfect. But our boys are very perfect in doing with other social media. Only thing, they are to be routinized, they have to be customized, and they have to be, a system is to be created for the social media. That is, will take 2-3 months of time, but I'm very sure our young boys will be able to do it nicely with their skill, with their ability, with their intelligence, and with whatever equipment they have.
Sir, can you share some information about the what kind of device tools are using in this pandemic situation for enhance their capability for corporate communication?
I agree. See here, now 3-4 tools are there already. Tools were there from 1990 onward, but they were not in vogue. You will be surprised these days, two tools, Zoom and Microsoft Link, Team Link. They are very big tools which are being used by most of the corporates. Some corporates are not using Zoom. They are depending on Microsoft Link, because Team Link, because they think it is better and it has more security features. But there are others also, like Cyber, Cisco's, Webex, then there is Handouts, then there is many other options which are available in the market. But for the time being, Microsoft and Zoom are the two tools which everybody is using. So even in, I think, ITPC and Airport Authority, they are using Microsoft Link. Even in Reliance, they are using Microsoft Link, not the Zoom. Because Zoom, they think it has some social insecurity features. So those are the tools which are being used now mainly. And then the other social media, which I mentioned you earlier, like Instagram, WhatsApp, Facebook, they're also big used. So that way, work is being done.
Mr. Bawa, Mr. Hindwan sir mentioned that this is there are lots of software, Zoom and other softwares also. And there are some precautions and guidelines issued by HRD, Home Ministry. So in this situation, what type of precautions we should follow as the corporate communication and as the important stakeholder in the serving the society?
Right, it's a good question, and it's a general worry and general concern in the minds of the people whosoever are using this. I tell you, we are in a phase of transition so far as this concept is concerned. But that doesn't mean that the video conferencing is something new. I remember that we had been using video conferencing in Airport Authority 7-8 years back. And only thing is that those video conferencing are happening in a very safe and secure network. And that's why there is no concern of data loss, data storage, or data stealing, or data encryption. There's no threat on that. But now, since a new concept of cloud computing, data is all in the cloud, And that's why the threat of stealing or threat of misutilizing data is there. And I personally feel the environment outside is very strong. And every day they are bringing more and more secure system. And over a period of time, whosoever is selling you a system, it will become foolproof. Only then they will stay in the market. And sustainability will come only through the safe and secure systems. Unsafe system will not be sustainable. That is my take on that.
Sir, in this situation, various companies like DMRC and oil companies are doing very good job as the increase of their Twitter followers, and they create a wealth of their viewership and their reach also. So question is that after pandemic, which method they can opt for the for intact them? ये सभी कंपनियां अपने दर्शकों और पाठकों और जो उनके उनको फॉलो कर रहे हैं उनको अपने साथ बनाए रखने के लिए किस प्रकार से आगे बढ़ेंगी?
If I understood your question in the right perspective, that you are asking that how to retain the followership of the medium which you have used.
जी हाँ, क्योंकि देखिए अभी अभी सोशल मीडिया के जरिए उन्होंने इस चीज को आगे बढ़ाया है. आज आप डीएमआरसी को देखें, उन्होंने फाउंडेशन डे अपना सेलिब्रेट किया और उनके ट्विटर हैंडल में बहुत बड़ी बड़ा इंक्रीज देखने को मिला है. इसी तरीके से एचपीसीएल समेत बड़ी कंपनियां हैं. तो आगे ये जो स्विच किया है उन्होंने, तो उसको किस तरीके से बरकरार रखेंगे आगे, आपको क्या लगता है?
I tell you how we should look upon it. The for the survival of business all around the globe, we had invented the currency system. So every country has gone currency, and we know that I am rich by so many dollar, I am rich by so many rupees. The same way for media fraternity, for the corporate communicator, their frequency is their number of followers and the number of likes. You see, the young generation, they are not looking how much salary they are getting, how much dollars they are getting. They are more concerned how much followers they are having, how much likes they are getting, how much time the people spend on the small screen on them. So their success lies in that. So that is the reason I personally feel each and every corporate communicator, each and every organization will have to devote extra efforts and extra time and even extra resources to ensure that they get more and more followers. Followers will come and go, but then few genuine will stay. We should make all efforts that followers stay with us. Now, how and why they will stay, we will have to identify what are their interests, what are their likes and dislikes, and we shall keep moderating ourselves. We will like we steer the vehicle on the road. If we are on the highway, we have to be extra careful. So I think that is the mandate for the next generation, to ensure that their followership should never decline.
As you earlier said that there is a big paradigm shift in corporate communication. This has happened with social media. So how the print media is responding the emergence of new media named social media, what kind of their reaction and print media kis tarike se pratikriya apni de rahi hai?
Anwar sir, would like to take on that?
Main is pe baat karna chahunga kyunki main aapko hairan ki hogi ki I was doing work for Lens also. And that was in a village setting, local village setting. And there, the वो जो पत्रकार भी होते हैं वो जर्नलिस्ट छोटे स्तर के होते हैं और वो हिंदी प्रेस को ही देखते हैं उस एरिया में, वहां की जो लैंग्वेज होगी उसमें ही देखते हैं. तो मुझे आप हैरान हो गए ये जानकर कि वहां ज्यादा से ज्यादा पत्रकार सोशल मीडिया पे बड़े अप टू डेट थे. मैं अपने सारे प्रेस नोट सोशल मीडिया से भेजता था, या तो ईमेल से भेजता था या फिर उनको व्हाट्सएप पे चैट करके फोटो भेजता था उनको व्हाट्सएप के थ्रू ही सारे सिस्टम भेजे जाते थे और वो रिसीव करते थे और दूसरे दिन अखबार में वो फोटो छपती थी। तो आज हमारा जो मीडिया है वो छोटा मोटा मीडिया नहीं रह गया, सारे भारत में इस समय सब इतने ज्यादा अपडेटेड हैं सोशल मीडिया से कि ये जो ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन हमें करनी पड़ी ये बड़ी आसान रही। अगर ये 10 साल पहले ना आती है सब मीडियम्स, व्हाट्सएप, फेसबुक, इंस्टाग्राम पहले ना आते तो प्रॉब्लम होती। ये असल में सब अवेलेबल है, ओनली थोड़ा टाइम हमको पहले एडवांस करना पड़ा है इस चीज के लिए। अदरवाइज देखा जाए तो हम सब ये काम तो ऑफिस में बैठ के भी करते थे, वहां से भी हम इंस्टाग्राम से मैसेज भेजते थे, वहीं हम व्हाट्सएप से भी फोटो में भेजते थे, हम ईमेल से भी उनको मैसेजेस भेजते थे। आप हैरान होंगे, मैं किसी फंक्शन का प्रेस नोट भेजता था सिर्फ ईमेल से भेजता था और बाद पे उनसे फोन पे बात कर लेता, जहां मेरे को डर होता था कि यहाँ ये नहीं छपेगा आज, ये ओवरक्राउडेड है, लेकिन वो सब छापते थे और अच्छा कवरेज मिलता था। कहने का मतलब आज हमारी साइड पे जितने हम स्ट्रेंथ पे रखते हैं उससे ज्यादा स्ट्रेंथ प्रेस और मीडिया भी रखता है। वो हर एक भी चीज उठाने के लिए तैयार है जिसको हम उन्हें देने के लिए खड़े हैं। तो इसलिए इस तरफ से तो हमें निश्चिंत रहना चाहिए। ओनली थिंग ये कम से कम 3-4 साल पहले आ गया है सब कुछ। अगर ये ठीक ठीक ज्यादा स्टेप बाय स्टेप बढ़ता तो हमें 2-3 साल में सारे भारत या सारा देश या सारी दुनिया इससे हो जाती प्रभावित। लेकिन अब ये अगले 6 महीने में ही सब हो जाएगा। लेकिन इसके नुकसान भी है। सबसे बड़ा नुकसान यह है कि हमारे स्पेसेस कम हो जाएंगे, ऑफिस में 25% एम्प्लॉयमेंट रह जाएगी, बाकी सब अनएम्प्लॉयड होंगे, क्योंकि कई कंपनियों ने तो कह दिया है 2025 तक हम अपनी स्ट्रेंथ 25% करेंगे। इसका मतलब दे हैव थ्रोन अ चैलेंज, ओपन चैलेंज दैट दिस इज गोइंग टू हैपन। तो इसलिए ये बहुत अनावश्यक भी हो रहा है, लेकिन अब क्या करें, इसमें डॉक्यूमेंटेशन भी हो जाती है, रिट्रीवल की भी आसानी रहती है, इसलिए सब लोग इसी को पसंद कर रहे हैं और आगे का भविष्य भी यही है। और बाकी बाबा साहब आप कुछ और जोड़ना चाहें तो जोड़िए।
नहीं बहुत अच्छा।
मैं सर हिंदवान सर से गुजारिश करूंगा कि वो जिस बात को आगे कर रहे हैं उसको जारी रखते हुए एक मेरा सप्लीमेंट्री क्वेश्चन है कि अपन 2-3 ऐसे उदाहरण देना चाहेंगे इस पूरे पैनेडेमिक के दौरान कंपनियों ने जो एक रोल मॉडल के तौर पर उन्होंने कम्युनिकेशन के क्षेत्र में काम किया हो।
मैं बताऊं कुछ थोड़ा आपको?
जी हाँ बिल्कुल, मैंने आपसे पूछा।
पहला चलो मैं एनटीपीसी एज ए केस ले लेता हूँ। आप हैरान होंगे, 2 एस्पेक्ट है, एक इंटरनल कम्युनिकेशन, एक एक्सटर्नल कम्युनिकेशन। जहां तक इंटरनल कम्युनिकेशन है उनके पास ई न्यूज़लेटर है जो ऑल ओवर इंडिया जाता है, उनके पास ई वीडियो मैगजीन्स है जिसमें वो अपने सारे फोटो भेजते हैं, और उनके पास ई न्यूज़लेटर है, वो ई मेल्स हैं जिसके थ्रू वो सारे सर्कुलर्स भेजते हैं। तो इंटरनल कम्युनिकेशन से वो बहुत अच्छी तरह जुड़े हुए हैं। इनफैक्ट दे हैव डिजिटाइज बोर्ड्स आल्सो व्हिच आर प्लेस्ड एट डिफरेंट प्लेसेस एंड ऑल दिस इज डन सिटिंग इन दिल्ली। नाउ ऑन द एक्सटर्नल मीडियम विच इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट बिकॉज प्रेस एंड मीडिया इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग। So I will tell you that they have very good access, and especially they are doing with the national press or the regional press. Both have wonderful access to all the systems available in the social media, and whatever they are sending is being done. I will give you an example. Recently, one of the communication agency approached us. I was working for a private firm, and you will be surprised. Through WhatsApp chat, he took the total interview. And the next day, the interview was in the paper. Even in fact, that CEO told me, sir, it has come out very well, but I was worrying only that he will publish something negative also. He has not done it. So congratulating from my side. I said, abhi baat kar sakte hain, there is nothing like that. We should be very clear to each other. So, aaj woh jamana nahi raha. Only thing, ye jo thoda pandemic ke karan thoda aage aage hai hum. 2-4 महीने हमने इसको एडवांस कर दिया, 2-4 साल एडवांस हो गया है, वही एक दिक्कत है। अदरवाइज आप देखिए, पहले व्हाट्सएप आया, फेसबुक आया, गूगल आया, अब तो गूगल भी अपना वो ला रहा है पूरा मीडिया आगा, जूम टाइप का सिस्टम, ताकि आराम से सारी दुनिया एक साथ जुड़ सके। और आप ये सोचेंगे ये इंडिया में हो रहा है, ऐसा नहीं है, ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड इट इज द स्टेट ऑफ अफेयर्स। आई हैव रिलेशंस इन US एंड दे आर ऑल्सो वर्किंग फ्रॉम होम एंड दे आर सेइंग दे आर मोर ऑक्यूपाइड नाउ देन व्हेन दे वर वर्किंग फ्रॉम द ऑफिस। I said, why? Kade, we have to submit reports. We have got targets now, which we were not having earlier. So that type of challenge has come. And here people will work more, people will deliver better, and people will save that time which they take in commutation and which they take in getting ready. So that time will also become part of the remuneration in the longer run. This is my feeling about the whole game. The Baba Sahib can.
My next question is with Mr. Baba sir. You have delivered speech in various colleges and management institutes. In this situation, what is your advice to younger professionals in corporate communication? This is important because our corporate communication offices are all. वहाँ पर आप देखेंगे कि young जो लोग हैं, उनकी संख्या काफी अधिक है. तो ऐसे समय में आप क्या advice देना चाहेंगे?
Yes, this question is very important, and whenever we go to such places, even after the class, they crowd us and they feel, hey, sir, you had a golden time, probably we will not have that much to enjoy. But I told them, you are thinking other way around. Probably when we started, we were hand to mouth, and then when we finished, we have handed over you to the silver spoon. Now you must convert that into a golden spoon. But then, yes, we have to boost their morale. We will have to encourage them, and we will have to ensure them that the world is not going to finish. The world has started a revolution, and that revolution is in the hand of next generation corporate communicators. I always tell them that you are the next generation corporate communicators, and once you are going to the next generation, you will have to face new challenges, and for those new challenges, you will have to bring in new technology, new tools, and for that, you will have to adopt to new culture. Now, since you have asked this, you give me some time, I will elaborate on this, because this next generation corporate communicator professionals are not going to take birth from all of a sudden. They have to be evolved and groomed from the existing lot only. So first thing is that they shall adopt digitization by heart, not by force. They have already started doing, so they must shall adopt digitization by heart, and then that shall they must ensure that they should not bombard their followers, their listeners, with too much of news, too much of content. That is their killer. So they will have to ensure that how they will have to develop a meaningful content so that people relish it, listening them again and again. And then everybody is concerned that fake content should go away. In a haste, we want to do in a haste too many. It is not important that you release every day a story. It is important that whenever you release a story, that should come factually correct. And Arvind is known for that. And that is the reason you people are known. Anybody who takes pain, the listener, the follower, understand that. And then we shall ensure that there is no inconsistency. Sometimes what happens, we forget that the followers are remembering what you said other day. So we should be consistent. And if we are making change in our statement, we should boldly accept, and we should tell them what made us to change our statement. That is the takeaway for the next generation. We have faced that. New thing, what is going to happen now? Hindwan Sahib rightly said that working from home is going to stay, and it is already there, working from home. Once working from home is there, it means that you are adding a new component of communication in your philosophy. Like I say that we have got now, up till date, we have got two type of communicator, internal communicator and external communicator, right? Where the family member of the employee goes, they are neither an internal nor an external. So now I say you will have to expand your communication to the family members also, because a employee who is working offline from home, when he is working, his family is listening him, looking about him, and at that time we must ensure that the corporate has to do something with that additional target population also, because that makes a difference. That gives a food to that man to serve that organization for him is working offline, and जब आप घर में काम कर रहे होते हैं तो आप एक घंटे दो घंटे के लिए काम नहीं करते, आप रादर 24/7 काम कर रहे होते हैं। कहने को आप दो घंटे दे रहे हैं पर आप 24/7 ही काम कर रहे हैं। सो दैट वी विल हैव टू इंश्योर दैट कॉर्पोरेट कम्युनिकेटर शुड एड्रेस द फैमिलीज ऑफ देयर एम्प्लॉइज आल्सो नाउ इन देयर कम्युनिकेशन एंड देन कम्युनिकेशन कॉर्पोरेट कम्युनिकेशन अप टिल नाउ इट हैज स्टार्टेड रीचिंग बट इट हैज नॉट रीच द बोर्ड रूम। Time has come, corporate communication shall be taken up by the top leaders. So leadership shall adopt corporate communication and we are not, time has come that corporate communication should not be performed by a third party, it should be performed by the leader itself. Only then the import, because the heat of the poor corporate communication is directly felt by the leader. So that's why he will have to take the baton in his own hand. And other things, I think already I have mentioned that we should, the next generation should be skillful, should be upgraded with the new technology, new tools. That's what is my take on that.
Could I add to this?
Please.
Yeah.
Two things in the reference, he was telling, Arvind was telling us about family members, programs for the family members. You'll be surprised in US, they have already started programs for the kids as well as family members, and which are shown on the computer itself for half an hour or 15 minutes, depending upon the time available in the slot and depending upon the meetings they don't have that day. So that thing has already started in the, and that thing we will have to bring in India also.
Right.
Because that's part of the, and I also agree with you, Baba Sahib, it should be part of the board affairs. That corporate communicator should have a representation in the board, and he should be a part and parcel to all the major decisions which are taken in the board. So that should be there.
Now I would like to invite Mr. J.P. Sarma, sir, to please put some questions to our distinguished guest before us.
इसमें क्वेश्चन पूछने वाली नौबत नहीं है, but मैं कुछ और सबमिट करना चाहूँगा. COVID-19 का जो पीरियड रहा है उसने एक नई कल्चर क्रिएट कर दिया. वो कल्चर ये है कि पहले जो मोस्टली कॉर्पोरेट कम्युनिकेटर्स 9 to 5 वाली कल्चर में काम करते थे, अब वो कल्चर से बाहर निकल के 24 आवर्स कल्चर पे काम कर रहे हैं, और कहीं से भी कर रहे हैं, रास्ते में कर रहे हैं, कार से कर रहे हैं, ऑफिस से कर रहे हैं, घर से कर रहे हैं, किसी मीटिंग में बैठे हैं उसमें कर रहे हैं, और उसपे वो बड़ा क्विक रिस्पॉन्स कर रहे हैं. नंबर एक. नंबर दो, अभी तक हम लोग ये मान के चलते थे कि हमारे जो स्टेक होल्डर्स है वो प्रेस एंड मीडिया है और हमारे एम्प्लॉइज हैं, हमारे शेयर होल्डर्स हैं, बट इस पीरियड में एक नया स्टेक होल्डर क्रिएट हो गया है, वो है हमारे फॉलोअर्स का और व्यूअर्स का. और उसमें से मैक्सिमम लोग ऐसे हैं जो हमारे एम्प्लॉइज भी हैं. एम्प्लॉइज अगर हमसे कनेक्ट होते हैं तो कोई बड़ी बात नहीं है, बट अगर अदर देन कोई एम्प्लॉइज हमसे कनेक्ट हो रहा है तो वो उस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के लिए बहुत बड़ी बात. कल मैं DMRC का एक प्रेजेंटेशन देख रहा था, उसमें उन लोगों ने एक नई चीज की, अपना सारा इवेंट मैनेजमेंट उन्होंने थ्रू वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग खत्म कर दिया, थ्रू डिजिटल डिस्प्ले खत्म कर दिया, लैक्स ऑफ रुपीज की सेविंग कर दी, कोई VVIP उसमें इन्वॉल्व नहीं हुआ एक्सेप्ट दैट मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर. नंबर टू, एक और इन्फॉर्मेशन उन्होंने दी कि पिछले 15-20 दिन में उन्होंने ट्विटर के ऊपर 1.5 बिलियन फॉलोअर्स क्रिएट कर लिए, जो कहीं पे भी उनके एम्प्लॉई नहीं है, दे आर द वेरियस मोड. और तीसरी चीज एक नई चालू हुई है, एम्प्लॉइज का एंगेजमेंट और हमारी फैमिली. चालू हो चुका है, जैसे उनके डिलीवरी बॉयज है उनको उन लोगों ने एज ए ब्रांड एम्बेसडर यूज करना चालू कर दिया है to circulate or to propagate their awareness message. नंबर टू जो हमारी बड़े बड़े प्रोजेक्ट में जो एम्प्लॉइज की फैमिली है उनके लिए कॉर्पोरेट कम्युनिकेशन ने उनको प्रोग्राम बनाना चालू कर दिया है। कहीं वो कुकरी की क्लास बना रहे हैं, कहीं कोई योगा क्लास का प्रेजेंटेशन दे रहे हैं, कहीं उनके लिए डिबेट कॉम्पिटिशन कर रहे हैं, कहीं और कॉम्पिटिशन करके उनको मोटिवेट कर रहे हैं कि वो ज्यादा से ज्यादा उस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से वो कनेक्ट रहे। तो तीसरी चीज और हुई है कि पहले ये माना जाता था कि सारे मीडिया के ऊपर जो नजर रखने का काम है वो कॉर्पोरेट कम्युनिकेशन का है, बट नाउ डेज हर तीसरा चौथा आदमी एक ऑब्जर्वर बन गया है, राइट फ्रॉम बॉस से लेके सुपर बॉस तक। बॉस का रिस्पॉन्स बाद में आता है, सुपर बॉस का रिस्पॉन्स पहले आ जाता है, व्हाट इज दिस गोइंग ऑन प्लीज सी। तो पहले जो हमारे कॉर्पोरेट कम्युनिकेशन सोचते थे कि ठीक है भाई प्रॉपरली टाइम पे रिस्पॉन्ड कर देंगे, अभी उनको इमीडिएटली मीडिया की क्वेरी का या स्टेक होल्डर्स की क्वेरी का या कोई मिसलीडिंग कैंपेन चल रहा है उसको उन लोगों को इमीडिएटली रिस्पॉन्ड करना पड़ता है। तो ये एक नई एक्टिविटीज हमारे उसमें ऐड हुई, मेरा इंटेक इसमें यही है। बाकी इंदवान साहब या बाबा साहब और कुछ ऐड कर सके इसमें?
Sir, as we have some time bound in session, so I want to conclude this session, and I would like to thank Mr. P.D. Hindwan sir for sparing time in this situation, and Mr. G.S. Bawa sir who has a great experience in the sector of corporate communication and as well as aviation sector. So we hope that next time हम एक नए प्रोग्राम के साथ इस सीरीज में कुछ नए इश्यूज के साथ हम बात करेंगे और नए मेहमानों के साथ। तब तक टाइम समय की एक बाध्यता के कारण हम इस सेशन को यहीं पर समाप्त करना चाहेंगे।
थैंक यू अरविंद जी, थैंक यू हिंदवान साहब एंड थैंक यू शर्मा जी, इट वॉज अ वेरी नाइस मीटिंग एंड गैदरिंग, एंड थैंक यू अरविंद ब्रिंगिंग ऑल ऑफ अस।
Thank you very much, Arvind. Thank you, Babaji. Thank you, Sharma ji. God bless you.
Thank you.